First at 6 a.m, the Immigration Minister's future is in doubt this morning after a decision which allowed a number of violent criminals to stay in the country.
Nine Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards is live in Parliament House with this story. Eliza, good morning. His department has also admitted it's stuffed up.
Yeah, Carl and Sarah, Minister Andrew Giles has been under fire over a ministerial direction he issued last year, which has essentially made it easier for foreign-born criminals to fight deportation if they have strong ties to Australia. This included a serial rapist, according to the Australian newspaper, and others accused of horrific crimes. But the Home Affairs Department has admitted to its own failings here, saying it did not inform the Immigration Minister about some of these legal challenges. Minister Giles has since cancelled the visa of one man accused of a murder in Brisbane on Mother's Day, and he's ordered an urgent review of other reinstated visas. But it remains to be seen if that action will be enough to save his ministerial career in the face of yet another controversy.
Eliza, thank you. On now, Australia's Immigration Minister Andrew Giles is this morning facing calls to go after it was revealed a serial rapist attacked 26 women and children but still managed to keep his visa. Malandiri, this is a result of the minister giving more leniency to foreign-born criminals with ties to Australia, the so-called Direction 99. This is a mess.
Well, this is a result of a High Court decision. I think we have to be really clear on that, Sarah. Of course, the circumstances since then have been incredibly challenging, but our government has done everything it possibly can legally within the framework to follow through and adhere to those orders. Of course, it's very, very difficult. Last night in Senate estimates, we heard the department give evidence, and I know that the minister wants to review the processes that the department should have followed and apparently did not. So he's certainly working to look at some of the internal issues within the department as well.
This Direction 99, though, is a bit different. I mean, Matt, should Andrew Giles step down as Immigration Minister? Is he up to the job?
Well, we've been calling for that for months now, but the most important thing right now is that Direction 99 is repealed, because this government's stubbornness now is putting at risk the safety of all Australians. They are being so stubborn in the face of clear and direct evidence that this direction issued last year saying that someone's ties to Australia should trump the security and safety of Australians has led to child rapists. I'm sorry to be so explicit, this is exactly on the record. It's led to child rapists having a cancelled visa overturned. And the judges in the cases, including the ex-Labor Speaker of Parliament, has blamed Direction 99 for having to make these decisions. So, this is clear. Mm. It is night and day. Just repeal Direction 99, and I have no idea why the government just won't make a common sense decision here to protect the safety of Australians. The only thing you could say is they don't want to admit they got it wrong. Mm. But look, stop being stubborn. Just admit you got it wrong. And look, if Giles has to go, whatever. But the most important thing is to get the law right to protect Australians today.
Malandiri, does Andrew Giles have your support? Can I just ask you, Malandiri, does Andrew Giles have your support?
Absolutely. Minister Giles is looking at what's going on here. It's very easy for Senator Canavan and others to throw the accusations and call for resignations. But the integrity of Minister Giles is this. He's worked in this space for a number of years, even prior to coming into government. He's very, very cognizant of the fact that the legal issues are such that he has to adhere to them. We are not being stubborn. We are being very thorough in this process. And I'm sure that the minister will be able to deliver as we expect he will.
All right,
under your laws, child rapists have been allowed to stay in this country.
Well, what about Peter Dutton?
That's happened, Malandiri.
No, what
change
about
it,
Peter
change
Dutton?
It.
Where has been the accountability by Peter Dutton? He released
on
a protection visa one of these people. So come on, Matt. Let's see that you're playing politics with
here.
This.
Just change
and
it,
we have
Malandiri.
A minister who's doing it. All in right. terms of the legal processes.
This is a very heated debate, that's for sure. It's not going anywhere. Thank you both for joining us this morning. Really appreciate it.